Ooh, I forgot that you can undock at different points in the Fort of Tsars. It's actually kind of legit, we'll be honest. All right, let's do this. Let's do this. I'm excited. But we just have to be on top of our reps, right? Do we do three up? Is that how you want to do it? So I'll go to Leon. Leon goes to Kyra. Kyra goes to Nobu. Okay. So this is my cat buddy. Good old cat buddies. I think I need Opti for the first. All right. Where's the little shit? Oh, here he comes. Busting in. Oh, baby. I'm so excited about this. I'm so excited in the right. Never done C5s as a group like this small, so this is kind of cool. Locations. No, it's fine. Don't make sure everybody's on the watch list. Ooh, I got a package. We are going to be doing giveaways today, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to be doing the Astero and Stratios as giveaways today. We'll get the Astero given out in a little bit. Spider. Oh, no, I mean, sorry. Shosendar, how's it going, Spider? What? I believe in us. Yeah, so I'm going to Leon. Leon goes to Kyra. Kyra goes to Nobu. Oh, is that down? Oh, I'm looking at Corp Chat, not Fleet. We can do this, Spider. We can do this. It's only three nesters. I mean, come on. It's just a C5 site. This is how we lose a bill. This is how we lose a couple bill. I don't, and I'm saving that. So I guess we'll take down towers first. Oh, I don't have any of my stuff in groups. I'm first target. One, two, three. There we go. There's the cap transfers. Okay, how do we do this? I want bouncers out. Move drones to bouncer. Get bouncers out. Let's shoot these guys down. I can take care of loot then, since you're gonna be dual boxing. All right, then we push F. That's all I gotta do. And hopefully they die. Oh no, we're not doing a giveaway. Oh my god, that's a lie. That's a lie. Oh my god, I can't believe that command still works. Giveaway, giveaway. Disable that. That one's a lie, Juniper. Sorry. I know, I disabled it. Why are you an idiot? We're supposed to do bouncers, I think. Right? I'm doing the further away sentries first. So the Leshak can have the close ones. Oh, watch your range, Skav. We are a 37 is our range with 29 optimal. You're at 39, so if you get aggro, we can't help you. Oh my god. Oh my god. He's gonna get himself killed. He's gonna get himself killed. All right. I'm hoping we're not gonna die or get dropped on. I mean, hey, worst case scenario, we get dropped on, we get to kill some people. I'm not gonna complain too much about that. Hey, we do have a giveaway. We're giving away a Stratios and an Astero today. Tomorrow is the Drekovac and what was the other ship? Guys, help me on this one. It's Drekovac and somebody Vigilant, and then Friday's the Nestor. There we go. Now we can actually rep this guy. Oh my god, he was living dangerously. Way too dangerously for my own good. Alright, I need to look at what we kill next. So those are dead. Bouncer's in. Hammerheads, I need to move to the Hammerhead group. Where are you, Hammerheads? There they are. Hobgoblins, move drone to the Hobgoblin group. Ogres, move drones to the Ogre group. Do I have an Ogre group? L.M. Ogre. Beautiful. So Hammerheads, I think, should be able to track these guys. We'll re-script them really quickly. I know, right? I may have a problem, Selexa, with the amount of groups I have. Maybe just a tiny problem. And by tiny problem, I mean huge problem. Huge! Kubwa, how's it going? With that ogre face, oh my god. Alright, I need to do... Alright, we're good. We're good. File, make a copy. Yes, make a copy. Okay, so we're on wave one. Wave two, the trigger of the cruisers. Wave two, the triggers the cruisers, but... Oh, wait, no. Wave one is battleships. The wardens are, so we kill the keepers first. Okay, so kill... Okay, one warden, then keepers. Got it. And so we would use our bouncers for this, right? Okay, mark which one to use to do. There we go. So number two, mark warden. Reps are going on Kira now. The Lashak's on the other warden. We should go to the other warden that's damaged more. No, it's not Mark II, it's the one that's damaged more. Let's just stay on that one, since you have your gun on it already. Okay, so this is an 1866 DPS wave. Right? I mean, you can do it, but you can't do... By different types, you mean ECM, Spider, right? Because CCP does not allow you to do that, which is... you're right, kind of annoying, I'm gonna be honest. I feel like they should be able to. Oh my god, this is going so much cleaner than I thought it was gonna go. I thought we were gonna be struggling. I'm having no problem keeping them repped up right now. Nestors will go for the one mark three, I guess. Well, we'll let him spool up on... He can spool up on one of the keepers. I don't care which one. Reps to Nobu. Which one are you spooling up on? The one marked one or two? Or three or two? Wait, why are my ogres back? It's more DPS if we let the Lashak spool up. It's gonna be interesting. Yeah, no, I kind of agree with you, Spider. I wish it would allow... I don't know why they restrict it like that. I really don't. So we drop down the wardens as fast as possible, right, on the last wave? Just to get some DPS off, just to get them off the field, the DPS and the remote reps. Reps to Kyra. Okay, so next wave is kill frigates, then cruisers or trigger. Yeah, next wave is frigates. Okay, sorry, I'm just trying to learn this. And again, if you guys want to follow along at home, I can leak the Eve survival. This isn't going too bad. We're alive so far. And I mean, we can always overheat our... Wait, no, overheating reactive just makes it go faster, right? It doesn't change how our reps are distinguished. Correct? But like, right now, it's just... That's it. There's nothing... I guess, do we go for frigates first? Is that the best way? Garv, you're out of range of us if you're the one with aggro. Okay, wait. These guys spawn down there. So we kill hammerheads with tracking. Should be able to take those guys down. Are you using hammerheads on the frigates out of curiosity? That actually might be better because I'm missing badly. We're gonna get hobgoblins. We're learning, guys. We're still learning. This is the first time I've done this with a small group in a C5 site. So it's interesting. It's interesting. We will. I don't think I'm going to be doing this all stream. We're just going to be doing it part of the stream. And when we're doing the Drifter fight, well, that's when we'll probably do the giveaway on the first site to get it really excited. All right, aggro's on Nobu now. And yeah, these are disruptors, not scrams, so we can micro jump drive away if we ever need to. Which is pretty lit. If the Leshak wants to kill cruisers, you're welcome to, by the way. You probably are having a rough time tracking the frigates. All right. Let's get these guys dead already. Okay, so then ogres on these guys? Is that better, or...? Ogre should be able to track at 200 velocity, right? What I'm doing. Let's see how we hit right now. Yeah, the ogres are doing pretty well, actually, I would say. But yeah, I guess it looks like ogres is the type to kill on this wave. Let's look at the cargo, or the blue loot. Ooh, baby, look at this blue loot. We're already at 88 mil right here. Let me just snatch that up really quickly. We already got an 88 mil, by the way, on the site. All right. This is going. I'm excited for the Drifter boss to see how that goes. I've never taken a Drifter boss in a small group. Again, usually we have like a Vindi with the double Vindi webs, and like we're rocking like 6 Nestors and 5 Leshaks, and it's craziness. So this is all new. Oh my god, the split aggro here. Okay, so Wardens first, then Battleships. It's amazing how fast the Leshak can actually take down the battleship solo. Oh, whoopsie. No, you can stay on there. Good, it's a Tech 2. That's how we need it. Tech 2 right there. Woo! Nice. Nice, nice. Sentinel's dead. Two more Sentinels. Okay, we're about to get the really big wave, by the way. The Wardens is what we kill first. Mark which one you want me to focus on, Leon. Just mark it with like a 1 or an X or something, and he can do his own Warden. And that should drop two of them quick enough. I'm dropping my reps up so I can... down so I can rep the right person. But yeah, overheating this just makes it so it cycles faster, right? Reactives? I'm pretty sure. Sleepless Wardens, 3 of them. Okay, Nestor's will go after 1. Who is taking the DPS? Kyra has it. All 3 reps are on Kiara. Go drones! Oh shit. And a little bit of overheating. Does Leon have all the reps on you? That's a lot of heat damage. Okay, we're good. We're good. Maybe. Yeah, I think we're good. Kiara's burning off. Am I crazy or... No, you just haven't moved. Oh, Skav, if they switch to you, you're dead, by the way. No, it's switching to Nobutatus. Oh, the cruisers swapped to Nobutatus? Everything swapped to Nobutatus. Oh, baby, here we go. Let's clench, guys. A little bit of clenching. Oh, baby, we're good. We're good. Yeah, we're holding. I can't believe it. Okay, so it's just a 50% reduction time. That's not too bad. Also, Gurr Pirate. Still mad at them. Yeah. I mean, the Omni works for this. So this is a PvP fit. So the... Yes, we have to refit. So he'll burn at us. Or do we have to move? There we go. We'll go to the Warden there. I'm going after 2 with mine. Or should we focus fire on 3? Aggro swapping to somebody else. Hey, reps are on Kiara. Yeah, it's a lot of damage. We did it! We're alive! We got 2 of the battleships down! We're holding! Oh, baby! Let's go! Let's go! This works! 3 Nestors can do this! Oh, man. I'm so excited. I didn't know if we were about to have 3 blown up Nestors or not. I'm gonna be honest with you all. I honestly kind of thought we were about to die here. I kind of thought we were screwed. But we're not. We're not at all. I know, it was a little sketchy, I would agree. So the Nestors go to A, I guess? Oh, man. One, two... 3. Yeah, it was a little sketchy, but we got it. We got it. So this is some PvE action in C5 space with triple Nestors. So per site... what time did we start this site, guys? Does anybody remember what time we started? Blue Loot is 235 mil. And then Drifter, I think. And then if we include the Drifter, you add an extra 300 mil, which we're going to try the Drifter. The Drifter, from my understanding, takes about 30 minutes to kill. So if I do a calculator, we got... Currently, we have three of us running, so four characters. We can just split it up per character. The Drift... And if we're rocking at 534... So a little over 100 mil per hour. You know, probably like 150 mil per hour, 160. I don't know. I have no idea when we even started this site. We'll be honest. Zero ideas when we started this. It's on Nobu now. Do you think our ogres can... we've already determined our ogres can track the wardens. We're good. No, that was the NPC dying, not me. Oh, that would have sucked if it was me. Woo! Do you guys know what time we started the site? I'm curious how fast we're doing it. Ooh, the Drifter thing just decloaked. So let's not trigger that until we're ready for this with our fits. So are we just going to swap off the tracking computers? Would that be the best? Because we don't really need to track him. Okay, okay. I have a grappler and a scram. Okay, so... That's our loot so far from this thing. No, to be fair, it was a little sketchy. If we go for higher DPS waves, like the Lashak was nice getting it down, but as long as we're on our toes, we can do it. I like the snowballs, man. Oh, having to be active. What is this nonsense? All right, let's refit. All right. We're refitting this off, this off, this off. And thankfully, oh, now I'm out of range of you guys. I can't refit. Oh, these... Loot. I need to get a little bit closer. Refit is 5k, cap transfer is 975. I know, right? Well, no, these are the cheap PvP fits. Well, not cheap, but they are PvP fits, so if we're ever to get drop on, it's literally we're a PvP fleet ready to fight, ready to roll. Alright, that, a scram, and now we are ready for... We're ready for this boss, dude. Alright, I do want to time this. I do want to time the Drifter boss. I'm curious how long it takes us from spawn to kill. I'm going to time the Drifter boss, how long it takes from spawn to kill, by the way. Are you refitting ready, Leon? I told you I was. Oh, like, refit already so we can get this guy. Yeah, so we have a mobile... So the reason for the mobile depot is for if I'm solo and stuck by myself, I can mobile depot, swap to this, and swap to this, and then I can, get out by my own. So if I, for some reason, get stuck by myself, I can still get out safely. Wait, what happened? Did you burn it out? This is taking this guy way too long. Why do I have so many omnidirectional tracking links as well? I have way too many. Okay, so we have the scrams and webs. Wait, Scarf, you're refitting something? Alright, got all the blue loot for that. Wait, are we good now, or... All right, let's do this. Yeah, shoot the decloak transmission relay. Hey, do you want to just approach me with both your characters and I'll approach the Drifter boss? That way we keep together. Yeah, yeah, that sounds good. And then I'll approach the Drifter boss when he spawns. It's on Nobutatus. Totally approaching him. Oh my god. Oh, this is gonna take me forever to approach because I'm webbed to all to high heaven. Maybe approach with your two nesters, honestly. Oh, you're right. Oh, I need to start the timer. Play. Cool. We'll see how long this takes. Well, no, I'm getting closer, I guess. I've gotten a couple kilometers. We just need... Who did it swap to? On a drone. Kiara. Yeah, he should be going on us every time. I'm almost in scram range. We just have to get him. He warps at half shield, is it? Recon, how's it going? Oh, is it half armor? And scrammed. Cool. This should be GG on him then. After forever. All right. How long do you guys think it's gonna take? How long do you think it's gonna take? Yeah, Kiara should not be remote. Two point 43 minutes. I think it's gonna take longer than 2.43 minutes to take this guy down. Is he armor or shield tank? Oh, 24.3 minutes. So we got a guess for 24.3 minutes. Is he... He's armor tanked, right? So that's where it's going to come in the most. I'm just going to keep it range current. I don't want to burn out of Kiara's range. Should I swap I'm gonna swap one of my cap transfers to Kiara. Yeah, I swapped one to Kiara. I'm doing 2 Leon, 1 Kiara. If you wanna, we can probably just do one as a combat, right? Probably drop a Repper, huh? Alright, I'm now 2. This is going pretty well. This is 300 mil right here that we're about to get. This is 300 mil. I'm excited. Okay, we're gonna give away an Estero right now while this guy this bad boy dies. So, this is again to celebrate the beautiful, beautiful... holidays that are coming up. We've been doing giveaways all week. We're giving away 2 ships every single day. So giveaway is going to run for 3 minutes once it starts up. Best of luck to everyone. So for a chance to win, !warp, anything between 1 through 4 gets you entered in for a chance to win that beautiful, beautiful Estero that you can rock, you can fly, you can enjoy. Later on in the stream, we're going to be giving away the Stratios. If you don't like the Celestial you're at, feel free to go to anyone you want. There's 4 up there. There's a gate, sun, and 2 planets. The planets are pretty barren, though. So choose whatever. you wish to go through. Whether it be random as well. And this is my favorite giveaway bot here on Twitch ever. Is it still on Kiara? He hates you. It's because you don't have a skin. It's because he doesn't have a skin. What's that? Yeah, he was on me at first, so I was the initial, and then he swapped. Oh, so it's just on Kiara for forever. So this is now mindless. Oh, the burn back to the MTU is going to suck. That's okay. I know, look at that. You really need to get a skin on that shit, man. We got, I have a skin. They're in a Mar in a container, and apparently you can't activate them. I never knew that was a thing. I never knew that was a thing. I'm going to be honest. All right. Me? I'm out of skin. The One Eden skin. The best skin at all. Zadar, welcome home. And 2 days off, that means that's going to be a lot of mining for you, isn't it, buddy? We're giving away the Astera right now. Exclamation point warp, get you entered in for your own skin, man. Or your own ship. This isn't going so bad. We're 5 minutes into this killing. We're 5 minutes in. Not bad. Remember, the closer you are to it, the more your grappler does. Not that it really matters. I think he's going 22 velocity right now. Yeah, it's a Nestor. It's the Nestor centipede. Ugh. Ugh. I mean, this works. So now, I mean, this was something we honestly didn't know would be something that worked, because we've never done three. Yeah, is Leon low on cap? Why do I have 100%? Because I'm getting all from Kiara. Get Kiara to do... Oh, no, that doesn't matter. Yeah, we'll go. How is Kiara on cap right now? Cool. Now I got the three. Astratios, obviously. Right? Our timer Absordio right now is we are at 6 minutes in to this fight. All right, baby. Let's see. Who's going to win this Astero? I'm pumped for you guys. Celestial 3 was the Celestial. So there's 4 there. Who's going to win out of the 4? Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Oh, Recon Cav with the snipe. Oh, man. Hit me up with that in-game name, Recon Cav, and I'll get that Astero shipped out to you right away. Congratulations, my friend. Woo! What do we got for your in-game name? Where is my Astero? I got a lot of Astero, so I need to find out where this one is. Astero. Wait. No, did you win yesterday? I think he won yesterday. Let's create contract. Reroll it? You really want me to re-roll it? Hey, you can win 2 days in a row. There's nothing against it. Are we re-rolling it? I don't mind. I mean, you won. It's fair. Fair is square, right? Or something like that. Your call, man. Your call. If you want to re-roll it, we'll re-roll it. If you don't want to re-roll it, we don't have to re-roll it. Wait, what was that, Leon? I'll swap one over to Kiara then. Cool. All right, we're re-rolling it. You heard it here first, guys. We are re-rolling the Astero. So we're going to do a brawl at the sun this time, though. So we're re-rolling. Recon Cav just wanted to participate, man. He just wanted to participate. All right. Exclamation point warp gets you entered in for real this time. For real. Best of luck to you all. What's that? We're at 8.5 minutes, by the way. Hey, Leon, what if you run... You're running two Reapers, right, on Leon, and you can't keep up? Okay, what if I do three Reapers and you do one from Leon? Yeah, let's do that. Because then I'll have my three cap transfers with you getting one less, and this should work with cap stable. Because Leon's only getting two cap transfers from me, because I'm doing two to him, one to Kiara. Leon's doing three to Kiara, and then Kiara's doing three to me. Because if Kiara drops, then I don't get cap. Oh, because we could just have Leon and me cap each other. Oh, but once Kiara runs out, then Kiara loses the webs, the scram, and the reactive. Hi, Icon! How's it going, buddy? I'm excited to see how much is this is total. Gonna be split. This is gonna be good. Yeah, we can try something different for the next one. Next one. It's going really good. I think my wife and I are gonna celebrate tonight after she does her stuff. Wait, should I do all three over to Leon? Oh no, you just swapped. Okay. So should I rip? Should I give my cap transfers to Kiara? Okay. We're running C5s right now. We're killing a Drifter boss at the moment. The Arthritis Tyrannosaurus. No, the Arithmos Tyrannos. It does have a decent Hull Tank. I think its armor and Hull Tank are about the same, to be honest. So we're going to see how this goes. Oh, baby. I don't know if it's going to be that much celebrating, but we're going to go out. We're going to eat some food. All right, who's going to win this time? I'm a little pumped. We're going to really get a winner for this Astero. Did Recon enter again? Did he enter again? He might have. No, but Koopwa7, congratulations on your shiny new Astero. Hit me up with that in-game name, and I will get that sent out to you right this second. Not this one. This one right here. Create contract. Oh, baby. Congratulations. What's that in-game name, buddy? Sinocologist MD. That is a name. That is most definitely a name. All right. Next. 2 weeks. Sinocologist MD. Congratulations for the Happy Holidays giveaway. Enjoy. Fly it. Blow it up, right? The in-game name? I know. We're going to have one more giveaway at the end of the stream, Prince. It's going to be a Stratios. But this is fine. But he's not dead yet. We still have Hull. He's got pretty beefy Hull, doesn't he? Oh, I was looking at it backwards. Look at this. Wait, shouldn't we be doing kinetic? So aren't Wasp kinetic? Or, wait, EM. Show info. Is there a drone that does this? It does EM damage? I can't think of a drone that does EM damage right now. Oh, baby. Okay. So for the timer for you guys, the Drifter boss, so prayer to... So would it be worth it to get Praetors or whatever for the EM damage? Because he has an EM hole on him for his armor. So, I don't know. Okay, I've got 18 kilometers to burn. Should I just warp off and warp back to my nester? Would that be faster? Yeah, I'm going to warp to the Baron planet and warp back at zero to the bookmark FMB number one. Yes, I want to refit first. Keep approaching me. I'll just burn. What are the drones going after? Someone's sending the drones after the structure, I think. Yeah, no hall resist. He dropped. 14 minutes. That took us 14 minutes to kill. That was pretty good. Way better than the 30-minute estimate. I'm not sure about the whole site. I don't know when we started the site is the problem. No, we're already 10 more K left. That's not bad, though. This whole thing is pretty... So at 14 minutes for 300 mil, so calculator, if we're at 300... Well, so 14 divided by 60... No, sorry. 300 mil... Divided by 4 pilots, all right? So that's 75 mil per pilot times 14 minutes divided by 60. The Drifter bosses are, that's not right. I'm doing my math wrong. It's 300 mil divided by 4 pilots, 75 mil per 14 minutes. So times 60 minutes divided by 14. So that's 321 mil an hour. We can do it tomorrow. Are we doing it again today? Or we're doing another site, right? That's not our only site. Okay. It's 2.5. Okay, yeah, we'll do one more. So the Drifter boss, if we were just doing Drifter bosses and only Drifter bosses, we'd be making 321 mil per character per hour. Nice. Group the cargo hold. All right, I have all the loot ready to go when you are. Oh my god, this is great. This is great. This is good is per hour, guys. So what we just got off of that site alone, if we split it amongst ourselves, 535 mil. So 535, 123, 123. Oh, whoopsie. I need to control X, control paste. Oh. Nobu Tadas Amur. Delete 1111. So we just made 134 mil. Kiara Leon made twice that because he's got two characters. We're gonna launch for self. I'm going to launch our bouncers. Launch these suckers up. Who am I I'm still capping Leon, right? Yeah, I put 3 cap transfers on Leon. Reps are on Leon. There we go. So, I don't know how long the site took. I just know how long the Drifter boss took. So, let's time site right now. So, reset. The Drifter boss was 14 minutes. So let's see here. Drifter was 14. It's about 1 bill a ship is how much it cost. So we'll find out how much this thing takes right here. And then we'll get a good idea of how much these things cost overall. Not shooting that one. No, 8 sites to break even. A little bit less than 8, like 7.5. Cool. We got the cap transfers going. No, not bad at all. We do want to experiment with Dommies at some point. Dommies, supposedly, you can run four of them to be equal to this. Equal. But this is not going too bad. Yeah, now you guys understand why I disabled the push-up bot, because if I had to do push-ups in the middle of this, that would be really bad. It's like, oh no, I have to rep, push-up, push-up, rep, push-up, push-up. You know what I mean? Like, be a little bit crazy up in here. That's all I'm saying. Just a little bit crazy. This is going pretty well. That's what we're finding out, Stigma. I didn't time it the first time, so I didn't know how long it took, to be honest with you. Oh, I'm not doing... Here, I need to do tracking anyway, so we'll do one tracking, one this. Hobgoblin's out. I'm being slow right now. We'll find out after this site how long it takes to get a good idea on that. Yeah, I launched my MTU, so we're good on that. Locking the rest up. Next wave is gonna be the one warden followed by keepers. Hey, do we wanna just have him work on the warden, one of the wardens, and we work on the keepers so he can spool up? That's my thoughts on this. So Nestor's can do keepers, he'll do warden. Nimrund, I don't think that's true. I think you just gotta start at something simple, because what we're doing is not a new bro thing. This is not a new bro thing whatsoever. And if you're a new bro, you should not be doing this. This is more advanced fits, more advanced knowledge of the game. New bro stuff, easy to get involved into it. Some people, now to be fair, I started with two friends. One of them thought it was too complicated, quit after the first week. The other one quit after 2 months. So it all depends. You know, and I loved it and I kept with it. I think as an alpha character, it's on Nobu. As an alpha character, give it a shot. Who cares? And honestly, having a corp will save that early day career type of shenanigans, to be perfectly honest with you. It'll help out a lot. But that's my recommendations. Yes, we'll go all keepers, you're going on warden. That way you could spool up for max DPS. What do these guys run for their resist? Yeah, yeah, we're good on that. Honestly, just having a corp to join Nimrund would be one of my strongest recommendations, is just find a group of people to join. Even if it's... And there's lots of streamers, lots of people who would give recommendations. But... That's what I think. If you can last 6 months. Well, and I'll take breaks. Like, I've taken month-long breaks. Sometimes I take breaks from just activities I do. Honestly, sometimes I'll be like, ooh, I'm done doing this shenanigans. Let's do something else. Like, I've left Wormhole Space for, like, 3 months one time, because I was sick and tired of it. Here, let's get a good look at my ship, man. Now that we're rocking the best Nestor fit in the game. No, you don't have to play it 40 hours a week, man. I mean, I know lots of people who play like 2 hours a week and that's it. They'll log on Saturday night and they'll do a little bit of roaming and that's all they do, you know? And that's okay. Faction Warfare is a great location to do that in. Also, if you just want to go out of a fleet one time in Nullsec, you just join one of the big fleets, go out for that for a couple hours and that's all you play. Maybe you go out and you do some missions for a little bit. Don't get bogged down in missions. Missions get a little bit annoying after a long time. But Eve Uni is a good group. I don't disagree. Yeah, that's a fun thing, Prince. And honestly, if someone just wants to do exploration with no PvP, Signal Cartel is a great group to learn that in. I mean, and honestly, I think... Oh, no scanner for... Oh, Scout? Oh yeah, I don't have any probes on this thing. Oh, I can refit though. All right, what's our trigger here? One second, I need to see trigger. Trigger is... Trigger our cruisers. The nesters can take down the frigates. Reps to Nobu, please. So, like, honestly, I think finding a group of people will make your enjoyment for this game go really high. Do you need other people to play this game to enjoy it? No, I've done plenty of solo play. But I think your enjoyment will peak when you get other people to play with. I think that's one of the beauties about EVE Online that makes it unique. Is just the community. But, I mean, I've done a lot of solo exploration. I've done a lot of solo missions. A lot of solo PvP. It's fine to do it solo. It's more fun to do it co-op. If that makes sense. And Sidar, yeah, Sidar solos everywhere. But you don't... You solo, but then you also chat with people, which is nice. I mean, honestly, Asten, even if you're in a Kestrel PvE or PvP, like, it can get really frustrating if you don't know what's going on. And, like, learning by yourself is a little challenging. They have redone the new player experience very well, so where it's a lot better than what it used to be. But it still can be challenging. Yeah, you're very social, though, in chat, Sidar. So that's a little unfair comparison there, buddy. Little bit unfair. Oh, that's awesome, Prince. Like, I've always wanted to do that, like, where I've been joined a corp where we establish ourselves. I mean, our group completely rotated to a new wormhole, and so we kind of established ourselves in a new wormhole, which was kind of lit, I'm going to be honest, to do. And it was exciting. It was something new, something interesting, and personally, I liked it. To give you guys an idea on the timer right now, we are 7 minutes and 50 seconds into the site, and we are finishing up the third out of 4 waves. So the next wave's the Dicey wave. So we'll figure out how that goes. So me and Leon will focus on Warden 1, and then you focus on Warden 3 on the next wave, right? We're still going to do that? I was going to say, the other option is we can all focus down one Warden. We just drop him down quicker. Okay, I'm fine with that, because I think the remote reps actually make it... And honestly, maybe it's worth us focusing down all 3 Wardens together, just because of those remote reps. Maybe we'll let him do the third Warden by him. Well, no, we gotta burn it down. Let's just try it this way this time. Alright, just a couple Sentinels, and then we're on the last wave. But yeah, I recommend, I mean, and you can even ask in chat if you'd be like, hey, does anybody have a recommendation from Corp when you start out? But I mean, start out, do the new player experience stuff, ask questions. Do the Sisters of Eve Epic Arc, ask questions. Then join a new player corporation, or a corporation. And give it a shot. And if you don't like it after that, then it's not for you, you know? And that's okay. This, I want to say this game is for everybody, but it's not. This game is not for everybody, but because of how alpha characters are done. Yeah, I mean, that's fine if you want to join before the Sisters of Eve Epic Arc. That's a fine thing too, Marlo. Yeah, I agree with that. But just how it is, like, with the alpha characters, it's always worth giving it a try. There's no reason not to. All right, Wardens are up. This is going to be where it gets dicey. Warden 1, it's on Nobu. Or, yeah, like, Sidar doesn't do that PvP stuff. He enjoys mining a lot. Oh, Leon, get me that. Give me that. Where's that third repper, Leon? Oh, and don't forget to sick the drones on him. Marlo, thank you so much for the follow. Malro, sorry. Thank you so much for the follow. Welcome. Nimrun, thank you for the follow as well. Welcome to the channel, my friend. Oh, baby, look at those memes. Look at those faces. Beautiful. Beautiful. I appreciate it. I enjoy this. And I know... I'll get it. I'll get Malro one of these times. I'm going to mess it up. eventually. Right? I love the faces. And again, I need more faces. Aggro swapping to who? Oh yeah, they have only a couple of swaps. I should be able to catch you, Leon, with just my reps, because you just have three cruisers. Now the battleships are gone. Yeah, get Kiara to you. Actually, all of them to you. Cool, so this Warden should drop fairly quickly. Oh, baby! Malro with that tier 1 subscription dropping it right here on the channel. Really do appreciate the support, my friend. Enjoy those emotes. Some of the best emotes on Twitch right here. Oh, man. And anybody who got those sweet, sweet Christmas emotes, make sure to thank Malro for them. And if you don't know, Twitch is doing site-wide every time there's a gifted sub or a sub or 300 bits or more gifted in a channel. People... Oh my god, that's such a cool emote, Siddhar! People get Christmas emotes. So, rack those up, watch Twitch in your spare time. It's great. Alright, there's three reps off. We're going to Kiara. Oh man, reps are on Kiara now. Alright, this is a lot less hairy this time now that we know what's going on. So this is, for those who are new to the channel here, this is the first time we've done this type of content on the channel. I normally don't do wormhole ratting on the channel, but I've wanted to do it, and we had the opportunity to. So we're going to do this for the rest of this site, and then Leon's going to have to run, which means we're going to be doing some exploration and PvP in our Astero is the plan from that. So this is going well. From my understanding, Spider, the holiday one should, hang around for a while. In the Christmas hole. That hat fits really well on that wormhole, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm kind of impressed with that. Kind of a little impressed. What? Oh, Ash, gotcha. Ash is the fun person to watch. I've learned a lot about the incursion stuff. Oh, this is the last wave. We just kill everything. Yeah, then we get the Drifter boss. Oh my god, this is lit. Yeah, no, Ash is a fun stream to watch. I watch him as his fleets. He's done a really good thing for the Triglavian incursion community. The fact that he offers those fleets is great. Well, I mean, okay, so this is the thing about EVE Online. EVE Online is, you are never going to be an expert at everything in EVE Online. It's impossible. It's not going to happen. However, there's a lot of individual people who are really good at certain things in EVE Online. And so you learn from them, so you become... One second. Rep Sonobu, please. You learn from all of them, so you become good enough to do it. So if you want, so then you can go and explore it. And if you want to become an expert in it, you can. And that's the beauty of EVE Online, is that there's just so much that you can't physically do it all. Oh man, all right, what's the next thing that we're killing? I want to go get a nice view. This one's gonna die next, so let's look at this sucker right here. Oh baby. There we go. Look at that guy, look at him go. See you later, alligator. After a while, crocodile, get wrecked. Gotcha. Yeah, and this is C5 ratting right now is how it's going with this. One second, I gotta cycle these down and swap. Okay, I'm gonna refit now then. So we're refitting for the Drifter boss. We're running three Nestors and a Lashak. We don't need the Lashak is just for extra DPS, which is kind of nice, I'm going to be honest with you. These guys have, these bad boys, I need to cycle down first. Which one's down? There's this. Now we need to get the warp scram on. Drifter boss needs 6 points at least. Plus we need to grapple him down. Nobutanas is refit. Okay, so it's all up to you, Scav, when you want to spawn him. And then just right-click Approach Me, Leon, with both your characters. Let's keep the chain up until the first swap happens. Who's got the aggro? Rep's going to Kiara, two of them. So I do a lot of wormhole stuff. Mondays I'm doing public fleets in Losec, or we're going to expand that out to different regions. That's what we do on Mondays, or we're starting to do Mondays, and the rest we're doing wormhole stuff. A lot of times I will do solo exploration, and then from there I will... I'll do solo exploration, and then from there I will call in... Oh, that was about 17 minutes, by the way. A little bit under 17 minutes. So overall, the site takes... Sorry, before I forget. So 17 minutes plus 14. I haven't seen the switch yet. We should get a switch in a minute, but it hasn't happened yet. Yeah, so 31 minutes. Not bad. So 31 minutes for 535 mil. 535 mil per site. Cool. Do you want to just put Leon's cap transfers on me then and don't worry about it? I need to get the scram on him. Oh, whoopsie. I scrammed the wrong person. That's not bad. That's actually really good. Oh my god, that's really good. I'm watching my range to Kiara because I don't want Kiara to get out of too much range on us. I'm going to keep the Drifter boss at range 5k, and that should be good. Yeah, she'll catch up to us eventually, and then I can close it a little bit more. That's not bad at all, though. Okay, so timing it with four people, it's 250 mil per hour per pilot. Nimrod, make sure when you sign up for account, use a referral code. I've got a it gives you extra SP. I have mine somewhere. Recruit. That's the one. Recruit. It's actually 1 million SP. It's 1 million SP. Please, you don't have to use mine. I'm not asking you to use mine, but use somebody's. I mean, don't get me wrong. I'd appreciate it if you use mine, but... It's 1 mil. There we go. So make sure you use that. Equals this times 2. Magic 14 command. What's the magic 14 command? Cool. Hey, as long as you get that, as long as you're getting stuff, I appreciate it very much, Rimnund. And honestly, I don't even know if I get anything. I'm going to be honest with you. All I know is that you get 1 million SP extra to start out with, which is great for the Magic 14. That's what it is. I don't think I have a command for the 14. I need to get it. Magic 14. And I don't necessarily agree with the Magic 14, to be honest, when you're first starting out. I think the Magic 14 should be a secondary thing, in my mind. The first is to kind of figure out what type of guns and systems you want to go with, then get a bare minimum enough for that, then go for the Magic 14. That's my thought process with it, at least. No, it's fine. We're just finishing off this drifter boss and then we're done, I think. Yeah, exactly. It's like a short-term goal. For some reason, the link I have is going to a dead site. Well, most of the Magic 14 is already given you. Okay, so it's all of Eve Uni's down. Gotcha. Yes, let's rat some more. I've never been so excited about ratting in my life, because this is so much harder and more exciting than C3's. I like how they do this. I like how they do this, because they did the Halloween one as well, and that was really cool. And now they got the snowballs wreck things here. So, that's pretty cool in my opinion. Yeah, and I think, like, CCP really, really did redo how they did the, everything. And now, like, the Magic 14, like, you get most of the Magic 14 already. Which is really cool. So wait, can you can solo Marauder this? Is the is per hour worth that? Because that's tempting. Oh, not enough DPS probably. I think I'll just skip to scanning when I'm solo for ISK income. And this is just one of the nice ways that we make ISK. So we're gonna come out at 350. So I have 356 mil for each of us. Is what it's gonna be. 356 mil for each of us. Because it's one bill, 70 mil split three ways. And this is in about an hour worth of running. This is great fun. Regular Eve launcher, don't do Steam. And this is a universal thing across all MMOs. Never, ever, ever, ever do an MMO through Steam if you can help it. A lot of times, because every MMO has their own launcher, and a lot of times there's incompatibilities between Steam's launcher and the MMO thing. No, it does not caps lockdown. And that took us a little bit of time. I was mostly AFK doing it. I was setting up my stream while I was rolling the hole. We did a little bit of rolling at the beginning, putting down the sights. So, I mean, it does take a little bit longer. I don't disagree with you, caps. If you don't have a choice, then you have to do Steam. You know? If you don't have a choice, it has to be. Wait, what? So, you'd have to top in an extra, you know, one person. So, like, my man hours, I probably spent, like, 45 minutes getting it all set up. Oh, Jumbo, I'm glad you mentioned it. Yes, Nimrun. It doesn't matter what race you choose. The only thing the race does is changes your starting skills a little bit. But you can train anything you want. Race doesn't matter. Starting group doesn't matter. None of that matters. Pick whatever you think is the coolest. That's my opinion. I picked Mimitar because I thought they were the coolest. I liked the way the Mimitar looked. I liked the aspects of their ships. I liked this emote right here. Where's the emote? Somebody needs to help me out with the emote here. Where is it? There it is. I just found it myself. No, oh, the rust is the best. Yeah, don't ever do it through Steam, unfortunately. I don't think any of the deals that happen through Steam, like all the deals that happen through Steam also happen elsewhere. So a great... Hey, I am not a doofus. Get out of here, Lyra. Okay, I'm a little bit of a doofus. I'm a lot of a doofus. That's okay, though. We accept that. So how do you guys sell the... Like, do you sell the loot, and then after it's sold, you do payouts, or... Oh, baby! Mauro, thank you. Oh my gosh, two of them! Mauro, thank you so much for the gifted subs to both Spider and Fenerula. Oh my god, that's too kind of you. Guys, enjoy those sweet emotes, and if you got any, all those subscriptions with the emotes, and if you got some emotes for the gifted subs, make sure to thank Mauro for that. And welcome, guys. Welcome, friends, to the stream. Too kind, too kind. By the way, anybody who has a sub, you're welcome to message me on Discord or whisper me on Twitch and get a custom ship for the giveaway bot. It's a ship for the giveaway bot, which we'll show off in a minute, honestly. We got a Stratios to give away still. And when we get all this wrapped up, we're going to give away the Stratios, and then we're going to continue on with scanning to have a little bit of fun with that. Oh, of course, Lyril, if you wanted to subscribe for free, if you had Amazon Prime, you can link that to your Twitch account to get Twitch Prime. And then with Twitch Prime, you get one subscription every single 30 days that you can drop on any of channel that you want. That's pretty much it. Yeah, Recon's like, no, I want this Stratios. And I'm thinking I'm gonna do two Nestors on Friday. I need to get out and buy the Nestor, but I'm currently war decked, which is causing a little bit of issues. But I'm trying to figure out the best way to do this. Right? Wait, so Twitch Prime also gets free Amazon Prime. Honestly, like, I would probably buy not the Twitch Prime, but there's one that gives you ad-free experience. That's actually pretty cool, too. But, I mean, we have Amazon Prime. My wife actually takes the Twitch Prime account. So she's got the Twitch Prime. But she's got the Amazon account that we have. All right, this guy is finally about to die. Oh, my God. The Drifter boss takes forever. Dude, can you just, like, not... Oh my god, Amazon Prime, the fact that I can order hooks. Like, I ordered my wife's present, and knowing that it was going to get here in a couple days, like, I think it was 3 days it took, which is fine, it's the holiday time. If I didn't use that, it would have gotten here on Christmas Eve. And we're not here on Christmas Eve, at all. Arithmos Tyrannos is about to die. Goodbye, Arthritis Tyrannosaurus. No, she uses her Twitch Prime to subscribe to me. My wife was my first subscriber, and that was because I forced her to. Oh, man. I hope you guys are excited about that. Oh, you know, I haven't actually done any of this Amazon Prime streaming. We just been doing Hulu. We've been actually watching a lot of Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Yeah, I have two reps. Oh, I have three reps on her now. This will drop to two. You want me to drop to one? I've heard good things about that, the Expanse. So, since we are both PhD students, we do Spotify Student. Spotify Student comes with Hulu for free. And there's the site. Goodbye, Drifter Boss. It's been good seeing you. Oh my god, that's a beautiful explosion. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Yeah, I think I'm gonna call it and I'm gonna scan out a little bit. That was a good hour of ratting and I mean, is it easier for me to just pay you guys and then sell this later? Sell it and then pay everybody off? Like, what's the best way to